Hi, welcome back to hashtag crack the boards. And today we will be discussing about the story of my life, which is the autobiography of an inspiring personality, Helen Keller. This is an exceptionally well-written book. If you read this book, it leaves you with so many thoughts in your mind and so much more motivated. So what will we be doing in this video? We'll first look at the important characters and try and give a character sketch to each of them. And then we'll move on to the important events in the story that you can use to make your answers even more comprehensive. So let's begin with the important characters in the story, starting off with the most important character herself, Helen Keller. Respect. That's the only word that comes in my mind when I think of Helen Keller, because she was a character of extreme grit and determination. At the age of 19 months, she was diagnosed with acute congestion of stomach and brain and was thus left blind and deaf for life. She was known to be a precocious child till she caught that disease. She had already learned how to pronounce a few words, but her life changed from there on. Initially, she took some time to get accustomed and to understand the fact that she was different, but her teacher, Miss Anne Mansfield Sullivan, changed her life forever. But it was Helen Keller's perseverance, and more importantly, three qualities defined her life. The first one being that she was resilient. She did not give up. When she learned a particular task, when she learned a particular skill, she did not stop over there. She wanted to learn something else. This is exemplified in her nature of wanting to learn how to read, of wanting to learn how to write, of wanting to come out of situations and come out as a stronger person. Secondly, she was stoic. She never complained. She wanted to achieve something at all points of time. Yes, she faced many controversies, the biggest one being the Frost King controversy, but she came out of it and she never complained of how rude life could be with her. Thirdly and most importantly, she was a student of life. She learned from life and learned from nature. And that is something we all must imbibe from her. So these are three qualities that defined Helen Keller. And that is what makes her such an inspiration for all of us. She read so many books. She wrote so many books and wrote this beautiful book for all of us. Moving on to the person who defined and shaped her life, Miss Anne Mansfield Sullivan. Miss Sullivan was a character of extreme patience. Even though Helen sometimes removed her frustration on Miss Anne Mansfield Sullivan, she never gave up. She wanted to give her life to Helen Keller. Whatever she could do for her, she did. And this is exemplified with the chapter 4, Helen Keller has said that before she entered her life was like a ship caught up in dense fog. She could see no light ahead. And she just removed all that fog and showed her the light towards achieving something in life. But there are few more statements that define the relationship between the two of them, and I'd like to read them out from the book. This is from page 40. When she came, everything about me breathed of love and joy and was full of meaning. Then she realized that a child's mind is like a shallow brook which ripples and dances merrily over the stony course of its education and reflects here a flower, there a bush, a fleecy cloud. How beautifully Helen Keller has described her relationship with Miss Anne Sullivan. But Sullivan was there for her at all points of time. Even when she faced tough time during her controversy, she was there. When she faced tough time during college, she was there. She was there at all points of time to support Keller. That too at such a young age. She was only 20 when she entered Helen's life, and she helped her, and she helped her come out a stronger person and a better individual who knew what she was strong in and who could persevere and who could go on to become one of the greatest personalities we would ever know. So a lot of credit must be given to Miss Anne Sullivan for Helen's success. Moving on to Alexander Graham Bell. We all regard him as the inventor of the telephone, but he too had an important role in shaping Helen Keller's life. And how did that happen? Because he was the one who guided Helen Keller and her parents to the Perkins Institution, where Mr. Anagnost, another important character, guided from Perkins Institution only, Miss Anne Sullivan came and entered Helen's life. So Dr. Alexander Graham Bell was like a friend to Helen. And even later on, he accompanied Helen and Miss Sullivan to the World Fair, where they met many people and they saw many, many artifacts. And it was Dr. Bell who explained everything to Helen. So he was an extremely helpful person and had a lot of empathy. He felt whatever Helen was going through and understood her so well that Helen actually called him a friend. Now, let's move on to Mr. Anagnost, the director of Perkins Institution, someone with whom Helen had a mixed relationship. And why was that so? Because initially, Helen was extremely close to him. They both would sit together, would talk for a long time, and would be at ease with each other. But it was the Frost King incident that changed their relationship with each other. Helen Keller would always confide in him, but soon Mr. Anagnost began to suspect Helen Keller and felt that she had plagiarized her story. So thus the relationship soured over time, but Helen still says that she regards Mr. Anagnost as a wonderful individual and she would always remember that relationship that she had with him. There are a few other characters that you must remember about, and their character sketch might also come. One of them is Miss Sarah Fuller, the person who taught Helen how to speak. Another is Mr. Keith, who was another tutor for her. Then Mr. Gilman, and also her sister Mildred Keller. So I hope that the character sketches are pretty clear. Now let's move on to the various events that took place in the book, and which can be asked in your examinations as well. The first important event is that of Helen learning about the power of nature. And that happened when Miss Anne Sullivan left Helen alone on top of a cherry tree. And then suddenly, she could smell rain. She could feel that the surroundings were pretty uncertain because a storm was about to come. She could actually feel the ruffling of branches and she knew that she was in trouble. But it was once again Miss Anne Sullivan's comforting arms that took her to safety. But from that day onwards, Helen came to know that nature had a lot of power, and it took her a lot of time to actually climb another tree. That was one incident. The second and the most important incident is that of the Frost King. Now, what is the Frost King incident? It was basically a story. The story written by Helen Keller. And this was published in the Alumni, and that magazine which was published by the Perkins Institution. This was released by Mr. Anagnost himself. And he was really impressed with the story, which was actually presented as a birthday gift to him by Helen Keller. But later on, they found out that this story was like a replica of another story written by Margaret Kay. And this was a story called The Frost Fairies. So she faced a lot of trouble over there as many people began blaming her. And also Miss Anne Sullivan, who was believed to have narrated that story to Helen Keller. They found out that it was beforehand, on one of the trips, another person narrated the story to her about the nature of autumn. And that had stayed on in her mind and she wrote the story, The Frost King. So Helen faced a lot of problems at that point of time. She described it as a very tumultuous time in her life, but she learned a lot out of that as well. Of course, her relationship soured with Mr. Anagnost, but the most important thing she learned was that before she wrote something, she would think twice whether those were her original thoughts or had she copied them from somewhere else. Helen also describes her college life, and this turns out to be an event in itself, because when she went to college, she faced a lot of problems. She faced a lot of problems attending lectures, and it was initially Miss Anne Sullivan who was narrating those lectures to her and writing it on her hand. But she faced one major problem, and that was a lack of time. So before that, she had a lot of time to think, to ponder, to learn, to read. So much of time was there for her. But now, with so much syllabus, with so much pressure to attend lectures and to make notes, she found it extremely stressful. And ultimately, she even wrote saying that it was not as good as she had thought of it to be. But she slowly got accustomed to that as well. That's what I told about Helen, that even though she faced few problems, but she knew how to come out of those problems and to get adjusted even in difficult situations. Now let's come to her love for books. She read many books, and it all started off with The Scarlet Letter, and then it moved on to Fauntleroy, and so many books, she read so many books in her life. And it's an inspiration for us that if she could read so many books, we actually have more potential and we can learn so much, right? Then let's move on to her love for other sports as well. She loved sailing, she loved canoeing. She even describes one incident when they were caught in, a difficult situation, and how the cloud had come up and they were like in the middle of a water body. But somehow the person who was at the helm drove them to safety. So she was someone who enjoyed that. But at the same time, she would also do knitting. Just imagine a blind girl doing knitting as well. She would love bicycling. She used to interact with trees. That is one great speciality about her. She loved interacting with trees, and she gave names to trees. So she was a person who just loved interacting with nature. And imagine, even though she could not see the Niagara Falls, she could not hear the sound of the water falling and all the beauty that was surrounding it, she actually felt it. And that is what she brings out in this book. She says that it's not necessary for you to see beauty. You can just sense it, right? And that's what happened. So I hope that this video was helpful for you. And I hope that it will help you in writing the long answer question. For long answer questions, you must remember that write down the keywords, the main points at a corner, and then try and elaborate upon them. If you use good adjectives, like in character sketches, it's very important to use the correct adjectives to describe that person, then you can surely elaborate upon them and write a beautiful answer which is about 200 to 250 words. So if you like this video, do share it with all your friends and do subscribe to my channel. Best of luck to each one of you.